Sarah with Spicy Pinecone, and today I am doing a remake soap. I am remaking Big Blue. This is one of my best sellers. It has a really clean, crisp ocean fragrance, and it's one of my all-time favorite soaps. Personally, I love the beach. I'm a beach person. My husband's more of a mountain type person, but if I had to pick anywhere, like if I won the lottery, I would buy a beach house. Now, Big Blue is one of those soaps I've been making for a while, but I always seem to switch up the design. I keep the fragrance the same, but I like to play around with the design a little bit. I think for this one, I might do an in the pot swirl and then take my hanger swirl tool and kind of swirl it up a little bit and then keep the top pretty much the traditional Big Blue top that I've kept for a while. Then again, I might change my mind. I have no idea. So it might be a surprise. Now, one of the best things about making this soap is that whenever I make it, it always makes my house smell amazing, like super, super fresh and clean. What is the... I'm trying to think of what the fragrance reminds me of. It's not like Irish, it's kind of like Irish Spring, but it's not Irish Spring exactly. I don't know. It's like a clean, like I said, a clean ocean fragrance. I can sit here and stumble and try to explain it all day, but that's exactly what it smells like, is like clean ocean. So I still have this white left over to finish up the top, and I'm just gonna scoop it out and put it over to one side. Okay, now I have my fork. Try to zoom in a little bit. Okay, trying to get it a little closer. There, okay. Now I have my fork, and this is only for soaping. We don't eat with this fork. This is only for texturing.
Head held high, even though it's not a lie that we knee deep in the dust. Killing time while pretending that we're fine, thinking someday we will burst. You and I are falling behind, and I'm ready to go get out while we hold. Now take my advice, take my advice. Let go, let go. I wanted you. I know you feel it too. Cut loose before we sink. We sink into the ocean's blue. The ocean, the ocean, the ocean. It takes some time, even though it's just a smile, but I hate it when I'm faking. With you all night in a body that ain't mine, thinking I am gonna burst. You and I are falling behind, and I'm ready to go get out while we hold. Now take my advice, take my advice. Let go, I wanted you. I know, you feel it too. Cut loose, before we sink into the ocean's blue. The ocean, the ocean. I hear we sink into the ocean, blue, the ocean.
The next step is just to set it aside for about 24 hours. It depends on your recipe, and then I'll slice it up and we'll see what we have on the inside. Now I have my soap all set out. It's been sitting for a while and it's ready to stamp. And I always like to test the little sample first. And I like the impression it left, so I know that the rest of the bars are ready to go. Now this one looks a little bit different from the others. That's because this is the end piece. I decided to stamp them all going the same way. If you flip it, you see that the swirl is on that side. So, actually, okay, I'm changing my mind. I do that a lot. Just on the spur of the moment, like, no, now I want all of them stamped on the swirly side. It doesn't really make a difference, but it kind of does to me. So now I'm going to go ahead and stamp the soap. Now the entire batch is stamped, it's ready to go up on the curing rack for about 4 to 6 weeks. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give us a big thumbs up, click that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time. Okay, I'm sorry, I keep laughing because something really funny happened today. I can't even focus on the soap right now because I am so kind of embarrassed, but not. It's, okay, I'm gonna break from the soap to tell you this story really, really fast. I can't get it out of my mind, and it is cracking me up right now. So years and years ago, my son wanted a Harry Potter birthday party. And me being the mom that I am, I thought I'm going to throw him the coolest party ever. He wants a Harry Potter party. I will throw him a Harry Potter party. The problem was I didn't know what Harry Potter was at the time. I knew that he was a little boy and maybe he could do magic, maybe he was a witch. That's all I knew. So I started doing some research, and now at this point in time, I know who Harry Potter is. I've seen the movies, I've read a couple of the books, not all of them, but at that point in time, I had no clue. So I was just doing research on the internet and I started buying stuff for the party. I actually blogged about it. If you guys follow my blog, which I haven't posted to in a long time, but I did back then, I'll put a link in the video description below that shows the Harry Potter party that I threw. But at this point, I was just buying Harry Potter stuff like crazy and just setting it all up. I still didn't really know the exact story, but I was just buying everything that I thought had to do with it. So I ended up buying this plastic human skull because I thought like Harry Potter was a witch and I would set this, you know, velvet tablecloth up and have this this skull on it to kind of set the mood. However, when I did it, the skull looked really, really creepy because it was super realistic, and I realized it wasn't appropriate for a children's party. So I set the skull aside because I didn't want to scare the kids. I didn't want them to run screaming out of my house. So I put it up in what was my soap office at the time. And Liam was very, very young. Liam is my youngest son, and he kept trying to go up there and explore all of my soap supplies. So I did kind of a bad thing. I told him that the skull's name was Mr. Bones and he would bite if he touched anything in there, which is horrible, I know, but desperate times call for desperate measures. Like, I didn't want him getting into my micas. He had already spilled some mica on the carpet and we were renting the house at the time, so I couldn't afford to keep replacing carpet. But anyway, Mr. Bones used to scare the kids from my soap office. They wouldn't mess with my supplies. We've had Mr. Bones for years. This creepy skull has moved around with us, and he eventually made it up into the attic, and we would only pull him down for Halloween because I'm not going to have this creepy thing on display all the time. So anyway, Liam discovers this skull in the attic probably about 5 months ago, okay? Like I said, we only pull it down for Halloween at this point. He discovered this thing like 5 months ago and he says, "Oh my gosh, Mom, it's Mr. Bones. I found Mr. Bones. Can I do some jobs to adopt Mr. Bones?" So I told him, I said, "Sure, if you want to do some jobs to earn Mr. Bones, that's not a problem. That's fine with me." So he did a few jobs around the farm and I gave him this plastic skull. That night, I walked in and I saw that he was actually sleeping curled around this plastic skull, which made me laugh hysterically, but I also kind of wondered at the same time, like, am I messing up my kids? But he seemed happy enough and it was fine, so not a big problem, right? Or at least you would think that it wasn't a big problem. So we have this burn pile on the farm where we have a lot of old trees and they're always losing branches. So we take the branches, we put them into a pile, and we burn this giant pile maybe twice a year. Well, we were burning the pile and we're all sitting in the chairs keeping an eye on it because we are responsible limb burners. And Liam looks at me and he says, "You know, Mom, I got something that I did." I said, "Okay, what'd you do?" And he said, "I gave my teacher Mr. Bones." And everything just kind of stopped. I was sitting there, the whole family was sitting there, and I turn and I look at Liam, and I said, "What?" And he said, "I gave my teacher Mr. Bones." So I look at Travis, and I have a million thoughts running through my head. First thought was, oh my goodness, this skull is creepy. He gave it to his teacher. I'm doing observation hours at this school. I can never go in there again. This is embarrassing. They're going to think we are weirdos. I look at Travis and I just bust up laughing because that's my first reaction. I just start laughing. I ask Liam again. I said, "You gave your teacher Mr. Bones." He said, "Yeah." Now I know how much this plastic skull meant to him. He did a bunch of jobs to earn this thing, and it's actually kind of like a tradition to bring Mr. Bones down for Halloween in our family. So I know that when he gave this to his teacher, it was done out of love. But this thing is not cute to look at. I'll put a picture of Mr. Bones up here so you know what he looks like and you will understand. But I look at Travis and the second thought that goes through my mind is just pure sadness. And then I just can't even believe that I'm sad about this skull. It's a plastic skull, you guys. You can buy it on Amazon. So anyway, I tell Travis, I say, "You have to get this thing back. I know that I can't do it because I can't keep a straight face. I'm already embarrassed. I know I will embarrass myself more. I am kind of socially awkward and this is already an awkward situation. That and me, it would not mix." So he said, "No problem. I got it." So the next day he goes to school and he walks Liam in and Scarlett goes off to her class. He goes in and he talks to Liam's teacher and he says, "Hey, how's it going? Good morning. I have kind of a weird question for you. Did my son give you a human skull by chance?" And all she does is looks at him and she says, "Yeah, do you want it back?" And he said, "Yes, please." Now, he took the skull and the funny part is he had to walk through he had to walk through the elementary school holding this skull, which he's trying to conceal, but he doesn't want to look like he's hiding something as he's walking through the elementary school because it's just a bad visual. So he's walking through the school concealing a skull. He gets to the car and he immediately texts me and he tells me, like, "I've got Mr. Bones." I was like, yay! And just the happiness that I felt to have this stupid skull back was ridiculous. And I promised Liam, I said, "We will get you something awesome to give to your teacher. I promise. I will make it amazing." So after I do my soap stamping and cutting and beveling, I need to go make something really, really nice for this teacher so she doesn't think that we are completely nuts. But anyway, I'm sorry. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that story probably at the end of the video so that those watching for the soap part of it don't have to watch it if you don't want to. I thought originally that I would just put the stamping at the end. I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna put the story at the end. Let's continue with the soap stamping.